not repent of his sin, he will be crushed under the footstool, under the holy feet of Jesus Christ. And so we're calling you today, repent and believe the gospel. Jesus Christ can heal you from
it viral, so that that disillusioned face can get viral.
You see, my friends, this is what sin does to you. Sin makes you insane. Do you see the insanity of sin? See, men run away from their only hope. When we reject God, when we reject the living God, when we reject what Christ Jesus has done for our souls, we reject the only one that can save us. We reject the only remedy that can save us from our blindness. And so this man right here, he thinks he's actually doing a service. Right now, he's actually bringing more attention to the gospel. So we thank you so much. But right now, this man is blinded by Satan in so many ways. He's blinded in a myriad of ways. But we don't want him to be blind anymore. We want him to repent and turn to Christ. We want him to repent and turn to the one who has placed this guy under his feet. We want this man to repent and to turn to Jesus Christ and believe the gospel. And so the Bible says this quite clearly, that if you do not repent of your sins, you are racking up more wrath. You are storing up more wrath on the day of God's righteous wrath, where his righteous judgment is revealed. And so a man like this man, he can be redeemed, even though his mind is darkened. Even though his mind is filled with all kinds of wickedness, this man can repent and believe the gospel. As long as this man has breath in his nostrils, as long as this guy is still breathing by the common grace of God, he can still repent and believe the gospel. But right now, my friends, I'm telling you today, God has mercy on this man that he's still alive. You see, he walks off in pride. The wicked walk away. They run when no one pursues. The wicked. There is no peace for the wicked, says the Lord God. There is no peace for this man. This man has no peace. When he goes home, my friends, he's going to say, oh, I did a good thing. But then when he goes home, there's going to be no peace for his soul. His soul is still dead in sins. His soul is still hostile to God. His soul is still at war with God. We want that man to call upon his only hope, Jesus Christ.